Sister Marcel can help me to read in the book of Mark 1:14. Mark chapter 1, verse 40 to 42. My English is not
40 to 42.
Yes, chapter 1.
And there came a leper to him, beseeching him, and kneeling down to him, and saying unto him, If you will, you can make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand and touched him, and said unto him, I will, be thou clean. And as soon as he had spoken, immediately the leprosy departed from him, and he was cleansed.
Amen. As we, I can ask you to just to be in your Bible, because if you don't understand something about my pronunciation, you can understand it when you read also the Bible. Here we, as we hear that Jesus, there was a man, as Jesus was doing the will of God, and the man came, a man came to him because he was sick with leprosy. If you want to know this kind of malady, you can read in the book of in the Old Testament, in the book of Leviticus, and you understand how God was explaining them about that sickness and how they must treat the person who are sick with that malady. And there was a man. Jesus was doing the will of God. That man came to Jesus. We can understand that to go to somebody, you must first know the person. Because you are working in the street and you just see somebody and you go to ask him for something. But first of all, you must know the person. For example, if you are looking for, let's say, for a job, you know that this person used to give people jobs. You have some information about that person. You know the person, and you can just go to him. You speak to him. You ask him the thing that you want. But here, a man came to Jesus. If we can understand clearly, the man could not go to Jesus could not go to the man. But the Bible says that a man came to Jesus. Why he came to Jesus? Because he knew that, he went to Jesus because he knew Jesus. He can hear about Jesus and he can also see what Jesus was doing. And for us to understand clearly is that Jesus was doing the will of God. And he came with a message that we can see in the only in this chapter, but in the verse 15, he was teaching the people because it was his mission. When he said in 15, the time has come, he said, the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news. That was the mission of Jesus. That was what Jesus was doing. And people was listening to what he was saying to them. And that man also was listening to what Jesus was saying. Jesus was not saying that, come to me and you who have a problem. Yes, he said that is another thing. And you can study on that way he was saying. But we are here. The message he was telling them, it was about the kingdom of God. It was not about your problem. It was not about your sickness. It was not about what you are worrying for your life or for your future, but it was for the kingdom of God. And today, we Christians, we are using, and we are speaking about asking, the word of God to go to ask for Him. But Jesus came not to tell us to go and to ask, but he was telling us that the kingdom of God is near. So you must believe, you must repent, and you must also believe to the good news. That was the news of Jesus to that man. That was the news that what the man hear about Jesus. Because when he hear and he believed, directly he went to Jesus to ask for something. So a question can be asked for us. You are reading the Bible every day. Since you start to pray, did you already believe in the word of God? Are you thinking about the good news that Jesus brought? Because when, if we take, for example, when Jesus was with Nicodemus went to ask him for something. But the answer of Jesus was about the kingdom of God. How you can get what you want? It was about the kingdom of God. So are you thinking about the kingdom of God? Or you are thinking about your own life, about what you will do tomorrow, and you don't know even you will reach even this afternoon? Are you thinking about that? Because here, as we hear that a man with leprosy came to Jesus. He didn't go to Jesus because people were following, but he heard first the good news of Jesus, and he believed on that news. That's why make him to go to him, to beg him. If you are willing, you can make me clean. If you are willing, that is the way also to ask. He went to ask. First of all, he heard about Jesus, but he went to ask. And the way he was asking, we can now compare it in our daily life, how we are praying, how we are asking to God things. If you are willing, you can make me clean. If you are willing, Jesus could also say, no, I am not willing. Because the way he asked, we can understand that, first of all, he believed to the message of Jesus, and he know that by believing, the Holy Spirit pushed him that Jesus is able also to make him clean. But he understood that the main thing was not for him to be clean. Thank you. The main thing was not for him to be clean, but first of all to believe about the kingdom of God, not about his sickness. Because the way he asked, we can understand it. For example, if somebody comes to you and say, if you want, that means the person know that you can want and you can also not. He know that. But when he comes, he asks you, if you are willing, you can make me clean. If you are willing, you can make me clean. If you are willing, you can make me clean. We can understand that Jesus knows that Jesus could not be willing for making him clean. But he went to ask for that. We can see in the 41, the second part. Jesus was